Hi Sagittarius, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and let's do a love check-in for you. Sagittarius, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So let's begin. Dear God, Goddesses, Angels, Spirit Guides, please bless this reading for Sagittarius and send them the messages they need to hear the most at this time. Thank you. So Sagittarius, before we begin your reading, let's take a blessing from Lord Ganesha and an angel blessing card and see what blessings we have now for you. So Lord Ganesha, a blessing card please for Sagittarius and an angel blessing card as well. A blessing or an advice please for my Sagittarius gang. Okay, so the card that pops out to me, Sagittarius, for you is this one, and Lord Ganesha, this one. Okay, so we put the rest back and get on with your reading. So Sagittarius, Lord Ganesha blesses you with the card of sustenance and reward. Okay, so Sagittarius, you're going to be pretty satisfied, I think, whatever you're doing, and I don't think you have any worries here, especially in the love department. You are going to get all your needs fulfilled itself, it seems, and there are big rewards coming for you as well. I wonder why this is. Let's see what your cards are going to say, or is this what you're looking for? I don't know. Let's see what your cards say and we'll figure out why these two cards have come for you today, Sagittarius. Sustenance and reward. So welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for all your support to the channel. I'm very blessed to have you here and I'm very grateful for all your support and love. And if you're new here, we welcome you to the Omkara family. You join us, we meet here monthly, weekly, weekends, all the time. So if you enjoy these readings, you join us, we welcome you in. So newbies, let me explain this. I'm setting down two sets of cards. One is for you, one is for the person on your mind, and in the center I have your mutual energies. The card I have here, bottom of my deck, Sagittarius, is the Nine of Swords. So still kind of a bit stressed out about something, it seems. Page of Pentacles. So Sagittarius, for the duration of this reading, this is person A for me, this is person B. You decide which side you resonate best with, okay? So the first card I have here for person A is the Page of Pentacles, Knight of Wands, Seven of Swords, the Hermit, Knight of Pentacles, and the Two of Wands. And for person B, I have the Seven of Cups, Seven of Pentacles in reverse, Ten of Wands in reverse, the Lovers, the Fool, and the Ace of Pentacles. Alright, so it seems here, Sagittarius, let's start with person A's energy. Sorry, I dropped my mic. Just give me a second. Okay, so Sagittarius, it seems with the Page of Pentacles energy, there is something that you started with, right? You started something new with somebody, even though I think there were a lot of options that you had at that point. This is person A's energy, Sagittarius. This could be you, this could be you. So I have the Seven of Cups on both ends, I think, in the same place. So there is a lot of confusion in this relationship. Both don't know what is it that, you know, what has happened here. I think a certain stagnancy has hit this relationship, Sagittarius. And you, I think this started out as a feeling of this was a soulmate connection, there was maybe a lot of love here, but also a lot of confusion as to what this was all about, right? And I think somebody went into reflection mode, went into hermit mode, trying to understand this connection, And the more I think they thought about it, the more I think confused they got. Because the person concerned here turned out to be a player. Somebody who was not consistent, who was in and out of your life, never stayed for too long, made you rather happy, but they were always pursuing their own goals and desires. Yes, there was this person may have given you a lot of passion, but this person was a Knight of Wands who came in with a lot of passion but sneaked away, and this almost felt like a betrayal each time. Yeah, this was something that you feel you need justice on. You're feeling abandoned maybe, or you feel this relationship itself backfired on you, because even though you had a lot of hope and dreams to have this Two of Cups with this person, it really didn't work out, and now I think you're looking for justice. So what's this Hermit card, Spirit, for person A? I think you've done a lot of reflection now on your own to figure this relationship out, Sagittarius, and I think now you're kind of dropping this person altogether. You've realized that this person is very, very, very immature. This person rushes in, rushes out. There is nothing solid with them. They bring in no peace to you. They maybe also have fights with you. And you're coming to a point, Sagittarius, that you're picking up your sword now and saying, hey, enough is enough, right? I want to bring back justice to my life. I can't be in this hermit mode all my life and keep waiting and thinking and worrying about you. I'm coming out of my hermit mode and I'm picking up my sword instead to say, listen, I call the shots now and I'm bringing justice back, and I'm not going to deal with any nonsense anymore, and I'm going to drop this relationship altogether, it seems. You're realizing, personally, you're realizing that this is a relationship which is going nowhere. Right? So I think you have coming to that place now that you're making a decision after a lot of choices being made here. You're taking back control of your own life, Sagittarius. You're taking back control, putting a stoppage to this relationship. You have been in deep reflection over this partnership, whatever you had with this person, even though there may have been love and attraction between the two of you, but now you're making a conscious decision to turn your back on this, right? Now you are no longer at crossroads, waiting, thinking, wondering. I think you're very, very clear that this is not something that you want to pursue. Yes, you do have a lot of regrets. You have a lot of sadness. You have a lot of regrets here. You maybe at one time did wish to, work with this person for a long term, maybe friendship or partnership or relationship. But now all you're left with regrets for the past. Maybe you feel you got played, you got fooled by this person, and you're kind of making a decision here to kind of, you've come to terms with it, even though there's a lot of sadness. You've dropped the ball on this energy altogether. Here you are, Sagittarius, walking away with a heavy heart, but very clear-minded now. You are the Queen of Swords energy. Masculine, feminine, doesn't matter. It's the energy of the card which says, no more nonsense, no more bullshit. I'm walking away. And I've done my reflection. I've done my being in solitude, thinking. I did love you, but I'm sorry, this is not going to work out for me. Let's see the other person. The other person, person B, I think maybe had a lot of options. From what I see, because they have not been investing in this relationship. They have had their eyes set on new horizons, right? They have the world in their hands. They've been planning, they've been thinking, what else is out there? What are my other opportunities? Maybe I have a lot of options in my life. Which one should I choose? Yes, I do have a lot of sweet memories with person A. This person is my friend for a long time. I have built up enough memories. I would like to continue, I would want them back in my life. I'd like to continue with them, but I don't think this person is willing to invest anything more than they want to, right? Seven of Pentacles is in reverse. So Seven of Pentacles, Spirit. Yes, this person is a bit selfish. right? They are out for their own gain. They don't make very just decisions. This is the King of Swords in reverse. They come across as a bit rude and harsh sometimes. They can fight with you. They are not practical sometimes. And with this kind of energy, they have not been kind of, you know, really investing the way maybe person A wanted them to invest. So one more card, Spirit, for the Seven of Pentacles and the King of Swords. One more card. Yeah, this person B has now made a decision of dropping this burden altogether. They don't want to really put in that much work or attention into person A now. They are more keen to build up their own stability. This person is the King of Pentacles here, has made a decision that I want to work on my own stability, my own happiness, and I don't want anything that's going to be burdening in my life, right? I don't want to carry anything forward which is not going to suit me. So like I said, a bit self-centered. Yes, this is a conscious decision made by them to start something new for themselves. What is this decision, Spirit? What's this decision? This person is wanting to start something new somewhere, Sagittarius. They are looking for the full Monty. They want the Ten of Pentacles. Maybe they want to get married, or they want to have long-term stability. They want a partnership which is equal give and take. They want full happiness. And they are deciding to start something new, it seems here, Sagittarius. Because I do see the Ace of Pentacles, which is in reverse. That means not starting it maybe with you. Let me just clarify it in any way. So Spirit, why is person A taking a fresh leap of faith and moving ahead to everything that person A wants? Why is the Ace of Pentacles in reverse? Why is the Ace of Pentacles in reverse? They don't want to juggle, okay? Maybe there is some reason why you both cannot be together. So this person doesn't want to go, you know, juggle anymore. They feel that any investment made in this relationship is not going to fructify in the long run. And they want something like solid. They want the Ten of Pentacles now, it seems. A solid foundation which they can, you know, have a legacy with, kind of a thing. So one card, Spirit, for the lovers in reverse. Why? What is this decision? Okay, one more. Yeah, they are finding this relationship to be a little burdening now, Sagittarius. And they don't want to be somewhere which is going to be stressful for them, right? Sagittarius, this could be you, this or person A could be you, I don't know. But the whole gist of the thing is that person B does love you, does have sweet memories of you, but they feel any investment put with you is not going to take them into the long term. So they are, I think, wanting to drop this relationship. They need a relationship which is going to sustain them in the long run. And that's the reason I think this card came out, sustenance. This is not a relationship which this person B thinks is going to last for a very long time. They are looking for something which can go forward and fructify and grow in the long term. And keeping this one alive is getting harder and harder by the day. And this person doesn't wish to be, you know, encumbered or stressed out any longer. So let's see what's in your mutual energy now. Death, Three of Wands and the Two of Cups. So yes, there is, I think this is your mutual energy. You both are realizing it's time now to end this relationship altogether. And I think you people are transforming this relationship and turning. Yeah, it's going to be hard, I think. It's going to be hard for both of you to leave each other. Sagittarius, I don't know what kind of relationship this was. This could have been an extramarital affair, or this could be something where it was impossible to, you know, keep this going for a very long time. So you both are trying to be strong in this transformation which is happening in this relationship. There is you can expect a small apology or a small love offer, but nothing that will really grow. Right? Nothing that's really going to go the long distance. there is sweetness here, but no forward growth here. I think you're both coming to a point where you're both turning your back now to this relationship and maybe having a talk regarding this as well, or moving forward. Yeah, you're both realizing that this conversation is about this, that yes, even though you people feel very attached to each other, this is maybe turning into a relationship where you feel obsessed with each other in a bit of an unhealthy way, right? This is not a relationship which can be sustained for very long. One more spirit for the Three of Wands. Three of Wands. Yeah, this relationship ending is not easy for either of you. I think you do both care for each other, and yes, you're both stressed out about it as well, right? You both know it's coming to a close and not very happy that it is. Two of Cups is also in reverse Sagittarius at the moment. That means now it's time to maybe bid adieu to this soulmate connection. Many secrets which will be revealed now, Sagittarius, about this person maybe. Even though maybe one person still wants a rebirth, this person B is not feeling very passionate to take this forward anymore. At best, you know, you both need healing now to come to terms with what has happened. And whatever has happened maybe has kept both of you stuck for a very long time. And neither of you, Sagittarius, are very happy right now. Ten of Cups is in reverse with the Two of Cups in reverse. That means this is a relationship which is now kind of ending because of, I think, very practical reasons here. Because as Lord Ganesha says, it doesn't have sustainability to go the long distance. Anything else for it? For Sagittarius? Anything else for Sagittarius here? Yeah, this is it may come to a point here, Sagittarius, that even though one person is still trying to manifest something, you know, which can make them happy once again, there is a lot of conflict and turbulence here in this relationship. And if kept going, it can lead to a tower moment which won't be that great, right? This can suddenly erupt into a fight or something. So it's better to kind of just be a little careful and be good to yourself. Don't get into something which... Use your intuition. Somebody here is not using their intuition very well. They are still not listening to their inner knowing. With the High Priestess in reverse, maybe somebody's not listening to their intuition, even though the signs, the writing is on the wall that this is not going to go the long distance, right? Also, many secrets will be revealed, and this may seem like a tower moment to person A when it's revealed that person B is maybe no longer wanting to invest. So that's all I have for you, Sagittarius. Stay strong. Whatever will happen, happens for the best. Remember that. And take care. Love and light. Namaste.